Welcome to our channel Right Click Education. In today's video, we will learn how to implement Angular Material Progress Bar in our Angular application. So without getting any delayed, let's get started. In your Chrome, type Angular Material. Open material.angular.io, which is the official website of Angular Material. Click on Components. In the left sidebar, you can see all the Angular Material components. So let's click on progress bar. First of all, we will see how progress bar looks like. So this is the progress bar. So progress bar tells us whether an event has progressed or not. So it tells us how far an event has progressed. Okay, so without getting any delay, let's implement it. But before that, let me tell you, there are four types of progress bar. One is determinate. So if you see, this is the determinate layout. Okay, if I click on indeterminate, you can see it keeps on going, right? So it's indeterminate mode of progress bar. If I click on buffer, you can see, right, this dot dot thing is going on. So this is the buffer mode of progress bar. Let me click on query. So this one is query mode of progress bar. So let's implement it. First of all, we will import the API that is needed to implement the progress bar. So copy this map progress bar module, go to your VS Code, open app.module.ts, scroll up and paste it. So copy this mat progress bar module. Under the ng module import section, we will paste it. Okay, so the import part is done. Now let's go to the official website, click on example. We will implement all the different modes of progress bar. So let's click on view code, copy this. So first let me write the code, then I will explain how it is done here. So it saves a lot of time also. If I go on writing the code, it will take a lot of time, right? Go on to TS. So in the TS, you can see we have imported these two. So let's import it first. Let me import the codes, then I can explain you how this has been done. Copy this also. So let's paste it. Okay, so this is done. So now let's go to HTML and see how they have done it. So we have taken a mat card and we have created basically different sections for different modes. So let me scroll up. So the first section, if you see, they have this radio button. So on click of those radio button, you can see the corresponding mode that I have already shown you. Okay, so let's get straight back to the progress bar. So if you see here, right, they have this mat progress bar. Okay, inside this mat progress bar, they have these color, mode, value and buffer value. These four properties are here and these all are binded. Okay, so let's see in the TS file what is this color, mode, value and buffer value. Go to our app.component.ts. So if you see, right, this color is type of theme palette which we have imported from angular material core. And this mode is progress bar mode. So we have imported it from progress bar module that we had imported in app.module.ts. So color is primary. By default, mode is determinate. Okay. Value is 50 and buffer value is 75. Okay. So in this way, we have configured everything. Now let's go to UI and see how it works. So open new tab, type localhost 4200. So if you see here, right, everything is here. I think some styling is missing. Let's go to CSS. We will copy this styling too. Okay. Go to your app.component.css, paste the styling here. Now let's again go back to localhost 4200. Let's see. Now you can see, right? It's looking much better. So we will choose color as primary, mode determinate. Okay. And the progress. Why this progress is not showing us? Because we haven't imported it. If you see, let me inspect in console, you can see, right? No value accessor for form control and unspecified name, right? So basically it's giving us some error. So let's fix this first. So go to our app.component.ts. app.component.html. And if you see, scroll up, we have used match slider, right? And we haven't imported anything for match slider, right? So first we will import match slider. So let's scroll down, go to slider, go to API, copy this one, go to your app.module.ts, paste it here, copy this match slider module, okay. Now slider is also done, so let's go to our UI and see. So if you see, right, this is determinate. Now let me click on indeterminate. So if you see, this is the indeterminate mode of progress bar. If I click on buffer, if you see here, right, this dot 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 thing, so this is the buffer, and we had given some number to buffer, right? That is 75. So you can see after 75% this buffer is happening. After 50% the indeterminate will happen. If I click on query, right, so if you can see, this is the query mode of progress bar. So these are the different modes. You can change the color also. Okay, so in this way you can implement progress bar in Angular Material. That's it for this video. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe our channel and press bell icon to get more updates. Thanks and have a nice day.